Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I'm going to tell you that gospel is by grace of our Father and not that everybody can have it. And there are people who receive gospel, they are predestined. Predestined means their nature is different from those of the rest. Now, today you have Antichrist dominating the churches. Antichrist, mostly they are the one who are the hireling of Mammon. They work for Mammon and they pretend that they are serving God. If they are serving God, then God will pay them in his own currency, which is gospel. But if they are working for Mammon, then Mammon pays him in his own currency, which is pound, dollar, and whatsoever it is. So people who are making a living out of the dog collar, they are Antichrist. They are the blind guide of the blind, and no wonder they say, you know, that gospel is for everyone. So to please everyone, because to the blind, everyone looks the same. He can't see, so he can't see the difference between one who is enlightened and who is blind. So lucky are the people who are men. Spiritually men mean those who are masters of their own destiny. So if you do not follow anyone, but you follow your own inner man, which is what is in your heart, which guide you, or tell you, do this thing, do that thing, not to follow that this man says so, as the rabbi say, that do not work on Sabbath. And these people, blind to spirit, they sit on Sabbath without even, can't make even a cup of tea. Never mind working, you know. And Sabbath was supposed to be devoted to philanthropy, which is the work of God. Because they are blind to spirit, empty. So Jesus came to fill that spirit into the hearts of the people. But the blind, they love darkness to light. And the result is still visible. If you go around and see some of these Jews who are educated, who have everything, but on Sabbath, they say that Rabbi has told us not to work, so we're not working at all. And even some houses get on fire on Sabbath, they have to ring a rabbi to get his permission what to do. So you can see how stupid they are. And Jesus came to fill their hearts with the Spirit of God. Spirit of God is common sense. So common sense is Holy Spirit, and the Spirit with capital S, which is the Spirit of God, is called extraordinary sense. So the gospel originates from your heart, and it rests in your heart and not in the books. Many people, they read books, and these Bible is made such a way that it gives you cross-reference. So if you ask any of these church people, what does this mean? Then he will start, open his Bible and start reading one passage after the other and so and so. And he does not understand what he's reading. But in his heart He satisfied himself that he has read it. So the gospel does not rest in the books. Gospel rests in your heart. And when it rests in your heart, then these books, they are under your, you have overpowered them. Or the books are under you and you are above the books. So you don't go by what is written in the book, but you go by what is written over your heart. And this writing over our heart, St. Paul said the gospel is written not in ink on paper, but over the tablet of your heart. So, Samaritan woman at well, John 4, as you know from the parable of the neighbor, these Samaritan people, they were living Christ of living God. The Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person, he did not ask what tribe you are, who you are, or whatsoever, but he just picked him up, looked after him, and paid for his look after. That is, he was spent his money on philanthropy, which is the work, doing the work for God. So this Samaritan woman, she also had read the books, you know, or got the knowledge from the rabbi or some other place. But when Christ Jesus met her, she being a woman of spirit, she engaged him into deep discussion. Whereas the same people, Jewish people, when Jesus used to go in Jerusalem, those people who are drunk with the Torah, they only know what is written, Moses' law. And as John 9, the born blind person, Jesus has stressed that those blind to spirit people in Jerusalem, they were just happy with the letters of the written Torah. They don't want it to know the gospel of God. And these people, Jewish people, they used to hate the Samaritan. And that is what the Samaritan woman said when Christ Jesus said for water. She said, "You Jew hate us, and you ask water of me." But when Jesus engaged her into discussion, because she was a person of spirit, so she was so happy. And she was enjoying the company of Jesus against those Jewish people in Jerusalem who were drunk with the old wine of the letter. They did not want it to know. They did not want to know Jesus. So you can see the comparison between the Jewish people and Samaritans. The Samaritan people were white-hearted people. That is what Jesus said, "Look, the crop is ripe. Look, the white-hearted people, white crop." Whereas the Jewish hearts, they were black, full of sins and hypocrisy. So, please preach gospel from your heart, and not read the book and quote, "Look, here it is written, there it is written," and to just impress upon the book other people. That is what the Jewish people used to do in Jerusalem, to impress upon the other people. They would read Torah from here, there, and all that. And those people were far better than the present people who go to churches and have the New Testament in their hand, and they keep on flicking this page, that page, And this is it, they are dead in spirit, and they will hate you.